Money's great. It's one of my favorite things in the world, but it's not everything. Wouldn't it be awesome if your employer could pay you with a visit to the doctor, or an all-expenses-paid cruise to the Bahamas, or even your entire college degree? It might sound weird, but some employers do actually offer these as compensation in addition to your paycheck. Well, not these things exactly, but you'll know what I mean in a second. These types of non-monetary compensation are known as benefits, and they can add some serious value to your employment. In this video, we're going to go over some of the most common benefits employers will offer to their employees. Let's get into it. There are certain benefits that you will receive from any employer no matter what. These are known as mandatory benefits, and employers are required by law to provide them to anybody on their payroll. Federal mandatory benefits include Social Security and Medicare contributions, unemployment insurance contributions, and workers' compensation insurance. Social Security and Medicare are federal assistance programs that take care of retired citizens. A small amount of your pay is automatically taxed to pay for these programs, 7.65% to be exact, and your employer pays the exact same amount as you do. So, in a way, this benefit is like your employer paying half of your contribution themselves. With unemployment insurance, you get the peace of mind that, should you lose your job through no fault of your own, you'll still have a little income to take care of yourself until you find another job. Unemployment insurance contributions are even better than Social Security and Medicare contributions. You don't have to pay a single cent. Your employer covers the entire contribution. The final mandatory benefit that employers have to provide, well, in every state but Texas, is workers' compensation insurance, more commonly known as workers' comp. If you're injured at work, workers' comp will pay for your medical expenses. Even employers that aren't required to offer workers' comp still often choose to, because it keeps you from taking them to court over an injury. Any benefit that isn't required by law is known as a voluntary benefit. Voluntary because it's up to the company to choose whether or not to offer the benefit. Now, the question of whether to offer a voluntary benefit or not might seem like a no-brainer. Less benefits means more money in the company's pockets, right? But really, it's not quite that simple. See, benefits are seen as an investment in the company's most important resource, people. Providing more benefits keeps employees loyal to the company. Kind of a you scratch my back, I'll scratch yours sort of deal. So most companies offer a wide range of voluntary benefits to keep their employees happy. One of the most common voluntary benefits, and one that employees frequently say is the one they most care about, is health insurance. We'll learn about how health insurance works later on in the course, but let me tell you this now. It's expensive to pay for it on your own. But if you join an employer's group health insurance plan, you could get good insurance at a fraction of the usual cost. Similar to health insurance, some employers will also offer dental and vision insurance for cheaper than you can get for looking for it on your own. Another common voluntary benefit that people look forward to is paid time off, or PTO. Some jobs just leave it at that, PTO. While others will split it up into categories like sick days, personal days, or vacation days, with specific requirements for using each type. Pay time off is exactly what it sounds like. By using PTO, you can get paid even if you don't go to work. I'm currently saving up my PTO days so that I can get paid to take a week-long cruise. Oh, I can smell the ocean breeze already. part of investing in your employees means paying to make sure that they're the best employees that they can be, which is why plenty of employers offer continuing education benefits, which can come in many different forms. Some will pay for you to travel to conventions where you can meet others in your profession and learn from their expertise. Some will hold professional training days to help everybody become better at their jobs. And some will even help you attend college and get a higher degree by loaning you money and letting you work it off, or just outright paying for your tuition. Continuing education benefits are another one of those benefits that ranks pretty highly on young people's radars. Think about it. If you were getting started at a job and you had your whole life ahead of you, wouldn't you be excited for the opportunity to learn, grow, and rise through the ranks quickly? I know I would. If you want one final reason to pay attention to benefits, how does the benefit of being able to comfortably retire sound? Many employers will set up a retirement account for you, set aside part of your pay to be automatically contributed to that account, and even contribute a portion of their own money to help grow your account even quicker. A hefty retirement account is essential for being able to retire and live the last few decades of your life in peace. So any employer that offers you this benefit isn't just saying that they'll care about you while you're working for them. They're showing you that they'll still care about you after you retire. Now, most benefits are structured in a way so that your employer pays for a portion or all of something that you'd generally have to pay for by yourself. But that begs the question, considering however much they're paying you and all the benefits they're giving you, how much total compensation is your employer offering you? Well, in the next lesson, you're going to learn how to calculate total compensation by factoring in everything your employer provides for you in addition to your paycheck. See you then.